In this tutorial, I'm going to go over the sweep feature using a guide curve, and in doing so, also introduce the idea of defining a reference plane using the normal to curve definition, which is very useful when you're doing sweeps. So sweeps are where we are taking a profile and basically sweeping it along some kind of a path to create geometry. So almost always with a sweep, you're going to draw your path first. So let's just get onto our front plane here, and I'll just draw a spline for our sweep path, and I'll do a simple curve, something like this. Okay. Now let's say I want to sweep a circle along this path to create something like a bent rod. The question is, where do I draw the circle? Because I don't have any planes, I can't really draw it on the right plane here because it's in the middle of the path. I really want to be able to draw it at one side or the other of the path, but I don't have any planes out there that make sense. And really, you want to draw your profile so that you, in most cases, you want to draw your profile so that it is normal to the path, meaning it's kind of perpendicular to the path in a 3D sense, so that it's going to be extruded straight out along that path. So what we need to do here is actually define a reference plane using a particular definition type, which is called normal to curve. So I'm going to insert reference geometry, and insert reference geometry. Oh, I'm still in my sketch here. Exit my path sketch, and let's call this path. So insert reference geometry plane. And I'm going to select my path and one of the two endpoints here. In this case, it doesn't matter which one. And you can see when I do that, it automatically knows that I want to do this normal to curve definition type. Okay? So basically what that means is that the plane that is defined here is defined in such a way that the path, the curve that I selected, is normal to it at the point that I selected, meaning that the curve is coming straight out of the plane. This is exactly what I want for defining a sweep profile. Okay, so do this. Okay, let's call this my sweep profile plane. And now, if I start a sketch on this plane, it's real easy to draw my profile. The origin is right where the original curve is touching, my path curve is touching, and it looks like I don't have automatic relations turned on. Let me turn that on. Okay. So let's say I've got, that's my profile. That's the diameter of my bar stock or whatever I'm doing here. So I'll exit this sketch. And now I can do a sweep. So Sweatball space. It asks me what's my profile. I'm going to say sketch 2 here. What's my path? It's this path curve here. Okay. And so the profile is swept along the path. Easy enough. Now one more thing I can do is I can add a guide curve that changes the size of the profile as it's swept along the path. So let's do that. So I'm actually going to undo that swept boss base. Let me rename this to profile. Okay. So, and let's get this plane out of the way too. Let's hide this. Alright, so I'm going to do a guide curve now. Again, I'm going to do this just for convenience on the front plane. It happens to be the same plane as my path here, but it doesn't necessarily have to be. So I'll start another sketch here. And let's say I want to start something like that, and then maybe it's going to get a little thicker out here and thinner in here and end up flaring out like that. Okay. So I would expect my profile as it goes along here to get bigger out here, smaller in here, and then bigger again. Okay. So let's see if this would work. Let's call that my guide curve. Okay. So again, I'm going to do Sweatball space, what's my profile? This one. What's my path? This one. And then guide curves. Choose a guide curve. And I click on that, and it says no. Well, it doesn't say no, but it doesn't show me a preview. And when I click on OK, it says it's invalid. It does not intersect the section plane, which means it doesn't intersect my profile, basically. All right, so let's go back and fix that. I have to make sure when I'm doing my guide curve that it intersects the profile here. So I'm going to add a relation to help me with that. I'm going to choose the end of the guide curve, and I'm going to choose my profile, and I'm going to add a pierce relationship. Pierce means kind of what it sounds like. Basically, if I rotate this around, you can see that this profile on one plane is being pierced by this curve coming in from another plane, and they're coincident at this point. That's basically what the pierce means. Okay, so now that we've got that relationship in place, we can go back and try again with our sweatball space. So again, profile is this one, path is this one, guide curve. And I'll select that. Alright, so now I've got a shape where the profile is going along the main path here, but it's also being influenced by the guide curve in that the guide curve is making the profile larger and smaller as it goes along the path. Okay, so you can get a lot of interesting geometry just from that simple tool in the sweatball space.